Welcome back to a special Saints edition of the Hot Seat. On the hot seat tonight, Coach Jim Mora. It's not really the hot seat. Coach, this is the first time this week that you've been back in New Orleans since the Saints won the Super Bowl. Again, thank you for helping us out and co-hosting our shows. How was your trip back? Do you feel a different vibe, I guess, so to say, because the Saints are now Super Bowl champs?
Oh, I definitely felt a different vibe. But, you know, when I was here as the coach, the team, the great thing about the New Orleans fans is they've always loved their football team, and the excitement's always been there. Now, we had some pretty good teams, so I wasn't around a lot, you know, during really, really tough years. But, of course, now with the Super Bowl championship, the fans are – they love this team, and they always have, and they got something to be excited about. So it was fun for me to be a part of all the festivities that took place on Thursday and Wednesday and all, with the parade and the concerts and working with you guys and seeing the fan response in the stadium and the game and the win. And it's awesome. I love coming back here.
I know that you've been very modest as we walk around town and we go to the Superdome, but does it surprise you in any way, the response? I mean, you and I, just so people know, you and I walked into the press box and you got a standing ovation from the fans in that section, which I was blown away by. People saw you and they were, I mean, very complimentary, saying thanks for helping lay the foundation. Thanks for helping this organization turn a corner when it was coming out of its darkest times and never had a winning season. Does it surprise you how well you're received and how loved you are in this community?
I like it. You know, it makes me feel good. There's right. No question about it. I was here a few years ago when I got inducted. I've been here since then, right. But I was here a few years when I got inducted into the Saints Hall of Fame. And at halftime of the game, you know, you ride around in a car. And my last couple of years here were tough years. And I was concerned about how the response would be. And the response was very positive from the people in the stands. And I started tearing up and crying. I mean, not just tearing up. I had tears rolling down my cheeks. But, yeah, I love it. But, you know, the people here, that's the thing about the people here. That's New Orleans people. That's how they are, you know. Now, if I were to go back to Indianapolis, and we won some games in Indianapolis, and I wasn't there as long, but we were 13-3 one year, right. Went to the playoffs a couple times. They wouldn't, those fans would kind of just sit there and, oh, yeah, there's Jim Mora, you know. But that's the difference between Indianapolis and New Orleans. You know, the New Orleans people are that way, and I love it, you know.
I think that that's a great testament to the people here.
Yeah, it is. That's what it is. Yeah.
It is. It's a great testament. Yeah. You're right. Kind of, no offense to Indianapolis, but more vanilla and bland.
Yeah.
And here people have a lot of color and character,
right.
And they love the people that were so good to them. Do you feel like a New Orleanian still? I mean, you gave a lot of your life to this city and a lot of blood, sweat, and tears on that field. When you come back, do you feel like this is still my city? I know you're living on the West Coast now and you're a California guy, but do you feel like this piece or this city will always be a huge piece of you?
Oh, no, there'd definitely be a huge piece of me because I spent 11 years here. And when you get a response like I got last night when I was here for the Saints Hall of Fame, yeah, I mean, You feel loved, you know. You feel like people remembered what you did and all that kind of stuff. And I haven't been back a lot since I left, but I've been back a number of times. And every time I've come back, the people have been great to me out on the street if I'm walking around or, you know, whatever. So, yeah, it was a big part of mine, a big part of my coaching career, which was my profession for a long time. And this was the place where I spent the most time here in New Orleans. And it was a great time.
You talked about this kind of moving from your tenure here in New Orleans to what the NFL does now. Does it even surprise you a little bit? Because that was an unbelievable parade. That was an unbelievable concert. I know New Orleans can party like no other city,
right.
But that was still a huge event. And you've seen the NFL come full circle. I mean, does it surprise you that they have done events this big and have grown up and kind of just, you know, make these such, you know, premier events to come to?
A little bit, because but they've been doing it now for a few years, but each year it seems like they get bigger. And I worked for NFL Network for 5 years, and so I've been at some Super Bowls, you know, the week of a Super Bowl. It's almost like the game's anticlimactic down there because of all the stuff that goes on ahead of time. You know, the NFL has done a super job of marketing itself, and the NFL experience thing, you know, and the parade and the concert. It's amazing. Just for a football game, it's not even a Super Bowl. It's the opening game of a season and all the stuff that they do. Yeah, it's incredible what they do.
Coach Mora, before we go, I know that you didn't like when I said this. I think it embarrassed you. I'm going to say it again because we're wrapping up here and we're going to send it back to the studio. But I said that walking around with you from our set to the Superdome, I know the Stones and Mick Jagger played at the Superdome. Mick Jagger's not the rock star. When we were walking around with Coach Mora, Coach Mora was the rock star going into the Superdome.
If I get down every once in a while, I got to come back here for my ego, you know.
Well, please come back again for us.
All right, thanks.
All right, Coach Mora, thank you so very much.
Thanks a lot.
Great to see you.
Okay.